Alright, welcome back. We are in the Norfest Forest. We had made it to Storkholm, but I missed the dog whistle in the forest in the middle of my panic about stupid dogs. In the midst of my panic about, well, a lot of things. So, we are going to backtrack and hunt out where everything is. Now that I know I can kill those stupid, specters with a proper application of force. Also, try not to die. In fact, I think I'm going to run all the way back to get more heals. Because this is getting a little bit out of order. Something like that. Words, they fail me. There's probably hidden chests around, too. Not entirely sure that there are, but there's probably, if I missed one thing, then I probably missed more than just one. That's usually the way these things work. Okay. There's nothing down here. Ah, I gained a level. Life up 11, strength up 2, defense up 2, and luck up 3. Ooh, luck up 3. That's nice. I guess there was a bat sitting there. Okay. So this is probably going to be a very boring video as I, well, except for me dying. Because we're not actually going to be able to advance the plot any. Did I come from down there? I don't think I did. Check down here, see if there's anything down here. Okay, so I did come from down here. Come on. Lots of dying happening. Hopefully not my death. Keep checking. I had completely forgotten that it's here in this forest. What's up? Okay, this is the way I came. Stopped paying attention to a lot of things simply because those specters were bothering me a lot. Hey, there was a Majorok up there, that's right. Nope, nothing up there. nothing more in here. Nothing there. About down this way. Besides, I need money. Oh, momentary frames of invincibility. So awesome. Okay. I think I came from downwards. What's this way? Don't think I recognize this. Nope, here's a treasure chest. Hey, there's the dog whistle. Okay, well, since we're this close back to the village, we'll just go back to the village. And I will go search for anything that I missed in the forest later. Yes, death. Death to those, not me. I do love that move. It's very effective. Ow. 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 Maybe I should heal. Alright. Let's heal again. Medium bulbs are worth 70. Okay, it looks like I might be able to just kill the specters now. Looks like I might have enough attack to just kill the specters. Everyone's dead. Everyone is dead. Oops. This way. Not entirely interested in... come on. In, killing things that are a little bit out of my way. But I am still interested in killing things. So more XP is always useful. Oops. Let's equip this. I don't know if it'll have any effect on the... I can just kill them now. On the saber hounds that are out here, but... Oh, just die. Alright. Malik used dog whistle. Did it, Malik? The wolves are leaving! Okay. So, yes. This place looks like a strangely toned version of door appears broken and will not open. Of Crysta. Even down to pumpkins. Jack-o'-lanterns. Although that one isn't talking, so... Well, this door's opening. Ellie's house, apparently. Hey! Can I bash you open? Nope. Two treasure chests. A medium bulb, and... portrait! Okay. This is probably what I came here for. Portrait of Princess Ellie's family. I feel a bit jealous. They look so happy. Ellie doesn't look like the princess now. Listen, Malik. I can make these two people appear in front of Ellie. Malik, you saw the Morn, right? The mirages I created? If I show her parents, maybe the princess will be cheered up. But that's only if you, Malik, don't plan to get married to her. What? Well, let's explore around this place a little bit more. Oh, hey, my tail left. They're dead. They're not moving. The little fishies are not moving. Aw. Well, it's probably rotten food anyway. Okay. Doggy? Wow, there are a lot of dogs around here. Nope. Doesn't look like there's anything. I still have to check the rest of this place. You know, most of these dogs are standing in the places where, this was the Weaver's College. I wonder how Ellie is doing. Malik, what's the matter? I was just thinking about how I left my village. Malik, you have many memories of places I don't know at all. But, I have my own memories that you don't know, Malik. Wouldn't you like to know some? Meilin, let's hear them slowly some other time, okay? You always smoothly drop the subject. Okay. This does just trigger it again. It seems like the wolves are for the most part standing in the same places where, people and other sprites were standing. Yeah, for the most part, they're standing where other sprites were. Which is kind of interesting. Okay. Doesn't look like there's anything else around here. No. Alright. Out we go. Do you want to go back? Let's go back. Let's meet at the castle. Don't forget to bring the portrait before your interview. Parted at the forest entrance. Alright, I'm gonna go quickly back in here because I think there's some stuff. Right inside. Not entirely sure. I should heal that. Heal. I thought there was something over here. Maybe not. Guess not. Nope. I thought there was a treasure chest somewhere nearby. Or it might be just deeper in, but whatever. Okay, let's go back to the castle then. And deal with the new Ellie, this world's Ellie, apparently, who doesn't like me at all. Oh, it's you. What do you mean by that? That's so rude of you. You have the interview soon, right? Alec, you don't have to do anything. Oh, hey, I'll take that portrait. I have to remember those two faces. Meilin took the portrait. Are you sure it's okay? I don't know what you're up to, but be careful. Leave it to me. You better go, too. Let us not waste time. Cure the princess at once. What is this? What is happening? Ellie. Possible. This can't be happening. They died years ago. Not just them, everyone in this village. Lone survivor was this child, Ellie. I know. I had them all killed. Your Highness, we are but a dream. We are not of this world. We came to awaken the eyes of Ellie's soul. That is what you desire. Now, Ellie, arouse the eyes of your soul. Let your father and mother hear your lively voice again. Princess Ellie? Are you alright? Step out of it! It appears the princess is not well today. Today's interviews are cancelled. You waited to the end. Anyone, have this clown thrown out of here at once. Alec! Looks like things went well. Something looked odd. King went totally pale. Something in that girl's past. Did it really go well? I got chased out of there. No problem. Let's rest at the inn. I'm hungry. Okay. Malik. Can you hear me? World of humans is still but in infancy. To make the infant walk and grow require humans called geniuses. Can you hear their voices? Voices imploring to be freed from darkness. Cross tall mountains and head south. There, a genius bearing a babe to the sea requires your help. Okay. Dream of the old timer. Phew, what a start to a day. Said to head south. Is it just a dream, or... Oh, it's you. Careful if you're going out. The king died. They're claiming illness, but some are ruminating he was killed. Guess the groom hunt is off now. Awkward. Hey. Can't eat anymore. Meilin, we should probably go. I'm gonna save. We've probably overstayed our welcome. And while you may have illusions to cloak yourself in safety, I do not. King is dead. People are saying he was killed. Wonder who killed him. A lot of people really hated him, though. Forecast growth of towns. King's death signals a change. Growth depends on the new leader. Doors to free economy are open. The town can grow. Reward for A information. King Henry XIII has passed away. Time of mourning has come. Who I should talk to. Can't keep going on like this. Here the king is dead. Times are changing. I'm going to think about atoning my past sins in this new age. Lush Lewis is plain Lewis now. He's quit drinking. He's even started reading difficult books. Wonder what happened. Well, I guess let's go run around the town and talk to people. Who are you? What do you mean by just walking in here? I heard White Wind escape from the castle. I'm so glad and relieved. I do require more items. Buy that. That. Buy that. Okay. Let's see. Magic shop, I don't care. Fortune tellers. Lucky item is a flower. Well, I do have those two flowers. Hey, people. It's terrible. The king has died. There's no more taxes and no more decrees. Hey? There's nothing wrong with that. Gene's giving a speech about the country's future. It's exciting. Countrymen, as you know, the king no longer rules us. Without a ruler, we have gained an inalienable right to freedom. Time has come for all of us to move the country. Hereby declare my candidacy as the representative of the people. Naturally, anyone can become a candidate. Anyone else? I declare my candidacy also. I'm not smart, but I love this village and country. I can help. Thank you, Lewis. You must now choose your representative. Like to hold an election to determine your intentions. Like to call for recess to prepare for election. We ask that you evaluate the candidates carefully before you vote. Jean had to say it really struck a chord. Make people happy by helping make a better country. It's perfect. Disagree with Jean. Wealth without fulfillment is meaningless. We should all make and share what we need equally without favor. It's amazing Lush Lewis would say something like that. Calling on vote, he's so intellectual. King's death is springtime for lore. Where's Princess Ellie? Right, so long as there are those like Lewis. Like to use taxes the king held to develop our town. Enabling more economic freedom, people should get better lives. Happy by helping make a better country. Disagree with Jean. Wealth without fulfillment is meaningless. We should all make and share what we need equally without favor. Okay, so he's Marxist and he's more democratic-y. I forget the other words. My grandma always said to me, before you make a big decision, you should make a record of your tale. You should also pay heed to the opinions of specialists. Actually, there's a point. Growth of towns. Future town to be decided by who will be elected. Conservative Lewis wins. Town will remain unchanged. Progressive Jean becomes leader. Growth can be expected. Casting your invaluable vote, you should weigh the consequences. Okay. So basically, if I want to push this village forward, Jean should be in control. I have no problem with that. Hey, Lewis, you're a cool guy, but no. Okay. Don't think... Yeah, she's talking about the Storkholm deaths. Alright. Voting! Who should I vote for? Vote for Jean. He looked well prepared and dependable. Yeah, there's effectively five people who end up voting. Two for Jean, two for Lewis, and then you're the decider. Thank you for your cooperation. Now tabulate the ballots. Tabulation can take a while. Please return later. So, enter the fortune teller, leave the fortune teller. Have you tabulated the votes yet? Sorry to keep you waiting. We wish to announce the election results. Myself, Jean, 25 votes. For Lewis, 24 votes. Just one vote, I was elected the representative. I'd like to ask Lewis for help in the difficult role. I also beg all of you for your support. Okay, well, it's not quite as small as you look. To be honest, I'm relieved. Could be better for a town this way. Nope, I don't need healing. Progressive Jean can be expected to grow steadily. Jean will require time to build the town's foundation. Alright. Well, I think I'm going to call the video here, and next time we'll go off south, I think. Well, I just remember that there's something I need to do with at least one of those flowers, so we will, because I gotta go back this way, to give the flowers to that silent girl in the nomad's camp. So, I will see you next time.